Hi, so now we're going to talk about titration. So this will be chapter 11 in your nursing math book, and we're going to talk about titrating medication. What does that even mean? Titration means that it's the process of adjusting the dosage of a medication based on the patient response. So when we do titration, the answers that we're going to get will be in milliliters per hour. So let's go milliliters per hour, because it's a flow rate, volume over time. And what happens is if we look at this nurse, she's titrating medicine. She gives one drop, waits for some time, checks on her patient. If there is no response, she'll go give two drops then, because that's what the next titrated level was. After some time, she'll go back and she'll give more. After some time, if still patient does not respond, then you're going to give more. However, if the patient responds at any time during this titration, you can stop administering medications and then give the order as needed. So what happens is when we get to the end, see, we're dripping, and oh no, you don't want to get to this point. Before you get to this point, because you don't want to max out the medication. There's a maximum amount that you can give, and after that you don't want to give any more. If you do, then this happens. Oops. And you really want to contact the physician right before that happens. Okay, so let's see what an order would look like. If we look here, it says, suppose an order indicates that a certain drug must be administered with an initial dosage rate of 10 micrograms per minute and increased by 5 micrograms per minute every 3 to 5 minutes for chest pain until the response, up to a maximum of 30 micrograms per minute. The bag has a strength of 250 milligrams per milliliter. Calculate the initial rate and then construct the titration table for this order. So the initial rate, it says, is 10 micrograms per minute. So I'm going to say 10, and it's already in there, micrograms per minute. Remember that we're calculating, we're constructing a titration table for the IV flow rate. So what happens is you have 10 micrograms per minute. And we need to get it to milliliters per hour. So if I would end my calculations here, it would be in micrograms per minute, but I need to go into hours. So I'm going to times it by 60 minutes in an hour and cancel out my minutes. If I should end my problem here, it would be the answer would be labeled in micrograms per hour. However, it's not. I need it in milliliters per hour, so I have to keep going. Hours is what I need, so I need to get rid of my micrograms. In order to get rid of my micrograms, I'm going to look at my strength. And my strength says 50 milligrams for 250 milliliters. This says 50 milligrams, and this says micrograms. So I need to get 50 milligrams to read it in micrograms. So if I need to change it to micrograms, then I need to do my conversion from milligrams to micrograms. And for every 1 milligram, there's 1,000 micrograms. So this would be 50,000 micrograms for every 250 milliliters. So we didn't change the quantity of the milligrams to micrograms. We just changed we changed the number. We didn't change the actual dose. Because if you told your patient that it is 50 milligrams per 250 milliliters, it's the same strength as 50,000 micrograms for 250 milliliters. So we're going to use that as our strength as 50,000 micrograms for every 250 milliliters. And then I can cancel my micrograms. And now if I were to end this, it would be in milliliters per hour. And that's what I needed in milliliters per hour. So I'm going to stop and do the calculation. And when I do it in the calculator, I get 3. So 3 milliliters per hour. Okay. And then after I do that, I'm going to in titration, after the initial dose is administered, the patient is monitored. Cream, sugar, what do you need? What do you need? It says here, if the desired response is not achieved, the order indicates increase the drop rate by 5 micrograms per minute. What does it say? It increased by 5 micrograms per minute every 3 to 5 minutes for chest pain until a response. So if they responded, you're great, you're done. However, now that we don't have a response, we now have to increase it by 5 micrograms per minute. So it was 10 before, now it's going to be 15. So I'm just going to change this 10 to a 15 and recalculate. When I recalculate, then I get it to 4.5 milliliters per hour. And then I'm going to check on my patient 3 to 5 minutes later. And if there still has that chest pain, I'm going to increase the meds by another 5. So now we're at 20. And the 15 goes to 20. And I do the same calculations. When I do the calculations there, I get 6 milliliters per hour. And then I check on my patients in 3 to 5 minutes again. And if there's still no response, if there's a response, I can stop. I can stop titrating. That's how much my patient needs. We're good. But if there is no response for this chest pain, I'm going to increase it again by another 5 to get 25 micrograms per minute. And then I'm going to change my 20 to 25 and do the math. Once I do the math, I get 7.5 milliliters per hour. Check on my patient again. If no response, I'm going to go do the math again and increase it by 5. So once I get to 30 and I do the math, I get 9 milliliters per hour. Now, if I check on the patient and there is no response, then the maximum rate has been achieved, so I have to consult the doctor. Awesome. Again, the whole point in titrating is to get a response. So if there's no response, keep going until the maximum and then consult the doctor and say, listen, doc, something's going on. All right. So try example 1119. It's to induce labor that orders pitocin or oxytocin. And we're going to start at 1 milliunit per minute through an IV. We may increase it to 2 milliunits per minute every 15 minutes to a maximum of 11 milliunits per minute. The IV strength is 10 milliunits per milliliter. So go ahead and calculate the initial pump setting in milliliters per hour and then construct the titration table for this order. Go ahead and put me on pause while you try this yourself. And when you're ready, come back and see if your titration table matches my titration table. So I'm going to walk you through this. And it says the initial dosage rate then would be 1 milliunit per minute. It starts at 1 milliunit per minute, 1 milliunit per minute. And I need to get that to milliliters per hour, so I'm going to multiply it by 60 minutes in an hour. When I cancel out by minutes, I have my answer would be left in milliunits per hour, but I need it in milliliters per hour. So I'm going to keep going and leave hour there because it's good. But milliunits need to get out of there. So I look at the strength up here, and it says it's 10 milliunits per milliliter. Once I cancel out my milliunits, my answer will be left now in milliliters per hour. So now I can do the calculations. When I do the calculations, I come up with 6 milliliters per hour. And then I check on the patient and there was no response. So 15 minutes later, it says that I can increase by 2 milliunits per minute. So I'm going to increase it to 3. And then I'm just going to change this 1 to a 3 and do the calculations again. When I do the calculations again, I'll get 18 milliliters per hour. I check on my patient. If there's no response, I'm going to increase it by 2 more, so I get 5. And when I increase it by 5, then I'm going to get 30 milliliters per hour. And then I check on my patient again, and there's no response, so I'm going to give 7. And that increases to 42 milliliters per hour. And then I check on my patient again, and it goes to 9. And that will give me 54 milliliters per hour. And then this says there's a maximum of 11, so I'm going to go one more time. I know it says only 5 cycles, but why stop at 9 when 11 is the real stop time, huh? So I change that 1 to an 11, and I do the math again, and I get 66 milliliters per hour. Now, if you check on the patient and they still are not responding, then contact the doctor. Ah, go ahead, Garfield. The only way to drink coffee is through an IV. It's funny. All right, well, I hope that this helped, and I wish you luck on your project.